Welcome aboard, everyone. Welcome to the Four Listeners Podcast. With me this week on the microphone is the mighty Ganthor. What's up, Ganthor?
What's up, buddy? How you doing?
Not too bad, not too bad. Long ago, it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories. They're all that's left you.
That's poignant, I guess.
Yeah, man, it's a little bit sad, but yeah, we got a new spear this week, so I got to introduce myself. I am the Z-Man, and a little known fact, we've done this show almost 5 years. I just looked it up. October will be our 5th year anniversary. We've done, 230-something episodes, and this is the first time that Ganthor and I have ever done the show by ourselves.
Truly by ourselves.
Like, we've done it without spear.
Right, which was very fun and awesome.
Yeah, because we can go durr.
Durr.
But we've never done it without a guest host. We've had many different guest hosts, but this is our first time without a guest host, so it kind of feels a little weird.
Feels a little dirty, doesn't it?
It's like the first time I've had an intimate conversation with you just alone.
It's like we used to be like a threesome.
Right.
All the time, and now we're seeing each other on the side.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know if this is right.
It's like, how do I talk to you without talking about spear?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's weird.
Without making fun of him. I mean, we could do that all night.
Yeah, you can still make fun of him. It's still dirt.
Dirt. I'm in California. I can't do anything.
Do they not have internet in California?
Apparently they don't. Apparently it's impossible to participate in things like that.
Anyway, this week something must be done about kids on Facebook.
What's wrong with kids on... No, I support kids not being on Facebook. Facebook is a terrible, terrible thing for kids.
Right. So my beef is, it's the beginning of the school season. Everybody and their brother has been posting pictures of their children and their first day of school.
Oh, you mean that type of kids on Facebook?
Well, we got all kinds of kids on Facebook. Well, let's start with this one, because this is what pisses me off right now. And, you know, I can't go through my news feed this week without seeing, starting grade 3, 5, and 9, look at the kids in their new school clothes, and they're always having these signs with their whatever their things on it. And it goes back to that, as well as like when you have a baby, and that baby, every fucking week I got to see a picture of that baby with a chalkboard that says 3 weeks, 7 weeks, 10 weeks. You don't see me posting stuff like, oh, I'm 2,080 weeks old today.
Yeah. So that who cares, right? There's maybe one significant date as a baby, and that, you know, well, the birth date and then the 1 year old milestone.
Right, and then they start changing their profile pictures, so the picture of them is now the picture of the baby, and I keep seeing their fucking name popping up, and I'm like, I don't even know who the hell this is. And I try to look for pictures of them. I still don't know who the fuck it is.
Right. I hate people who do that with their profile page. Yeah. It should be a picture of you.
A picture of you that you can see your fucking face.
Right, so I know who you are. Yeah, exactly. Because what if, I'm trying to think of a scenario, like let's say you're out somewhere and you meet this, you know, this beautiful woman, and she tells you her name, and you go to look her up on Facebook, and there's 50 of her, right?
Right.
And you can't tell which one is which because none of them have a stupid profile picture of themselves.
Right. And you certainly hope it's not the one with the three cats on the picture, the four kids in a wheelbarrow.
That works in your favor, but if it's something stupid, right, like you can't tell that it's her, you might miss out on that opportunity even though you have her name.
Right.
So that's terrible. But I you know, I have kids myself, and we just did the first day of school thing for this year, so I don't have a problem with that. That to me is...
But who are you posting them for?
See, probably my mom, because I talk to my mom, but it's like I don't like to talk.
How often do you talk to your mom? How often do you call her?
Very rarely.
Yeah.
Unless one of us needs something. I mean, she would love to talk to me all the time, but it's like the conversations are very painful to me.
Yeah, it's hard.
I want to do anything but be on the phone right now.
So here's a weird question, totally off topic.
Love you, Mom.
Does your mom, when she calls the house, do you have a house phone or she call your cell direct?
Cell phone directly.
Like, would she ever talk to your wife?
The phone? She would if my wife answered.
Because that's been like a thing. My grandma's always call my brother, and like when they calls the house phone, which my brother still has, like his wife will pick up, and she just immediately goes and gets my brother, which makes sense, right? But she takes that personally, like that she doesn't want to talk to her.
Yeah.
That's super weird, right?
It is weird. It's awkward, right? Because it's like, I mean, I can't imagine that your brother's wife, your sister-in-law, has met your grandma that often.
She sees her probably 4 times a year.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's kind of, okay, I'm with you. That's weird. That's not normal. If it was like she met her at the wedding and that was it,
yeah,
then I would completely understand.
But I mean,
that.
Like, what are you going to talk about? You're going to just talk about your kids, which I guess is what the whole point of it is anyway. But
yeah, it's just awkward space-filling conversation because you know she didn't call to talk to you.
Yeah, how's work? Work's fine. Yeah, how's the house? The house is great.
Yeah, how's the nursing home?
Yeah, exactly. Right, because that's the question.
It's like you, Grandma.
It's like I don't want to ask any questions back. It's like because oh, who died this week? Because that's pretty much the only news she gives me is which of her friends have died this week, and that's super fucking depressing.
Right. Yeah. That's fantastic. That's what I have to look forward to.
Yeah. Anyway, back to the kids shit. So I'm trying to figure out, like I just avoided Facebook that entire week. It's not even that week. It was like 3 weeks because the schools start differently for everybody, right?
Yeah. I mean, I can understand that as from the time when I didn't have kids, they didn't really interest me that much.
Yeah.
But having kids and families and parents and brothers and all that stuff, it's just easier to post it there and kind of blast it out to everybody. Hey, look, here's what my life is like lately. Read it at your leisure.
It'd be kind of cool if there was a way that Facebook could auto-filter that shit. Like, I want to put on no children, no religion, no politics.
That would be a good feature, actually.
And then it would know that these get flagged. That, and I'd be like, yes, cats, yes, beer, yes.
You would choose cats?
I would take... Dude, I fucking love cat videos. I got nothing wrong with cat videos.
Oh, my God. That sounds like something Spear would say, and then we would torment him for mercilessly.
Whatever, dude. Cat videos are funny. They still make me laugh. But that would be sweet to be able to filter that shit. And I don't know how they...
That's a very good idea.
I don't know how they would do that automatically.
The same way they auto-detect who is in a picture, dude.
Yeah, they probably could figure that shit out.
Yeah, they absolutely could figure that out.
There you go, Facebook. Free one from the 4 listeners.
Next one will cost you.
Yeah. Because that would make things so much easier. Because, like, for me, you know, I don't have children. So I just post pictures of the beers I drink because, to me, beers are my children.
That you drink and ingest.
Right. And so
put in your mouth.
I post it out to everyone. But, yeah, I can see that, you know, people, friends of mine who have no interest in drinking may not be interested in seeing the pictures that I'm posting of the, I don't know, 100 beers that we drank last night or, you know, the stupid shit we're doing.
No, that's a good comparison, right? Because that certainly doesn't interest me. I mean, I like beer, but I don't care what beer you've drank because, one, it's not me drinking it, so.
But sometimes you can be like, oh, I wanted to try that beer. How was it?
Right. No, yeah, there's that. But, I mean, if you take it to the extreme, that would be the pictures of the food that you ate.
Right, and that's the same thing. That's why people post pictures of the food they eat.
That's even worse than the beer or the children picture. Kids pictures, there's usually some context like, oh, it's, you know, my daughter's first birthday. Oh, it's my daughter's first day of school. The food is just random contextless pictures of food that you could theoretically find anywhere. Oh, that's a fantastic looking burger from I have no idea where. So it's stupid.
It is stupid. Is there certain media platforms that are better for? Because like it seems like people love throwing that shit on Instagram and Pinterest, right?
Well, who likes looking at it though? I can't think of people who like to look at food that other people have eaten.
It's more. I guess it's probably more of like a way for someone to like journal it themselves, right?
That's probably a good way to look at it.
Because I think that's probably why people post all this shit on Facebook. And then sometimes I do it too. It's like, oh, at this point in time, I was so-and-so, and this point in time, I was this place. And it's kind of cool now that Facebook has kind of realized that too and saying, hey, 1 year ago today, this is what you were talking about. Or 3 years ago today, this was the big topic. And that's kind of cool to bring that back and be like, oh, I remember that. That was cool. Like my brother popped up like the other day, and I think I reposted that. It's like, you've been friends with your brother on Facebook for 7 years. And I'm like, huh. That's pretty cool, and it went and picked a bunch of pictures of me and him together.
See, that I like from the journal perspective. Like, you know, I like to check in places and take a selfie or whatever of who I'm with, like my family or my wife or whatever, for that very purpose, because you can look back through the timeline and have the whole context of, instead, you know, the old time equivalent was you take the picture and then you get it developed, and then if you still remember it, you write on the back of it when it was and where it was and who was in it. Now that's done automatically, so it's nice to be able to have that kind of built in, because I wouldn't do it otherwise.
Right, because then you got a scrapbook, you got to take the time, put it in, in a book. And
I've made one scrapbook, and that was a romantic gesture, and I haven't done it since. So
it's a hell of a lot easier now, yeah.
And maybe that's what it comes down to. It's just we're all lazy.
Yeah, and your phone does it for you.
Yeah.
For the most part.
I mean, that is the point of technology, so I can't fault myself for taking advantage of an enabling advancement.
I guess it's just on these certain things that's just like are so polarizing that it'd be really just having that filter option would be awesome.
No, like I said, that's an actually fantastic idea.
Like if I want to, I don't want to see anything about Kim Davis, right?
You can kind of already do that. I mean, it's not wide or generic enough to work, but I imagine they'd be getting there. But being able to just predictively or proactively say, I don't like seeing pictures of cats or I don't like seeing political stuff, that would be great.
So then you'd be like, I don't want to see anything about mass shootings anymore. Yep. And just kind of hide that out of your life.
I don't want to see anything about presidential candidates.
Yep, that would be a very popular one coming up, or football, if people don't give a shit about who they were rooting for.
Yeah. See, but I feel like then it just becomes like a self-selecting or a self-reinforcing medium.
Yeah, but that's what people like.
I guess. I mean, I like sharing the stuff that people need to have their faces rubbed in.
Like?
Things like it, you know, waking people up to the world for certain things. But then there are other things that I can't stand, like prayers for Peter and
yeah, all that shit.
That's angels like, for Angela. It's like, you know, this is way too depressing.
I saw one the other day. It's some 20-something-year-old girl. I don't know what happened. She fell on a cruise ship, cracked the back of her head, and now she's fighting for life because I guess she got a brain aneurysm or something.
Yep.
I'm just like, that just sucks.
There's nothing I can do about that. Like raising awareness, okay, yes, that's a tragic situation, but there's nothing I can do. You know, it's not going to change. It's just that has ruined my day. Thank you very much.
Right, and there's no awareness being had about it. It's like she fell. I mean, sucks.
So the thing, you know, I'm not trying to make it political, but like the other stuff, you can look and you can, like I said, force people's eyes open and say, hey, you know what? Look, this stuff really does happen. It's not as uncommon as you might want to think it is. You need to look and read about this stuff because your viewpoints are incredibly sheltered and incorrect.
Then I can't be ignorant.
Right. But that, I mean, people, the ignorant just gets turned up to 11 and then they try even harder to avoid it.
Oh, I just love reading the comments on any of those kind of things.
He was asking for it.
Yeah. It's Obama's fault.
Don't steal something if you don't want to get shot.
So back to kids on Facebook. I mean, the one weird thing I think out there is that you have a kid. How old are your kids?
6 and 7.
6 and 7. So do they have a presence on Facebook?
No, absolutely not.
When do you think it's appropriate for them to have one?
18.
No.
Maybe 16.
You don't think so in high school?
I don't know. Because, see, I think of all, like, the sexual predators and those types of people who cruise Facebook.
But high school, they should be fine, right?
I don't know, because I also get all the posts about, you know, so-and-so's been missing since Friday, please help, last seen, you know, and they're usually, like, teenage kids. So I have nightmares about that, but I don't want to socially stigmatize my kids by saying, you know, by them being the kids who aren't allowed to have phones, who aren't allowed to have Facebook or things like that, but I don't know how I'm going to deal with it.
Yeah, as soon as they get the phone, they're going to get the Facebook or whatever the new thing is
Yeah, it's probably something that we don't even know about, but that's really huge in that market, right? By the time we find out about it, that means it's not cool anymore.
Right, and that's kind of what's good at Facebook now is that it's super not cool with anybody that's young.
Right. Do you remember when you used to have a .edu account from particular schools enabled before you could join? So that's what it was like. And now I go through, like, people you may know, and it's like some 75-year-old jackass who doesn't know how to use a computer. You know,
every time my uncle posts something, he tags, like, the 17 people he knows in the post because he thinks that's the only way that we'll ever see it.
Well, that might be if they blocked him. But that just ruins it for everybody else who's like who's friends with you, because then they see you're tagged in a post.
Well, I turned on the thing that I don't put shit on my timeline until I approve it.
Okay.
So that's... Every time I get one from him, I'm just like, hide.
Oh my gosh.
But
what a nightmare.
Yeah. But going back to the kids, the thing again is that, you know, some kids are coming up that they're already like having an entire Facebook profile because their parents have been tagging shit all the time with their pictures on their profile, or some people are actually creating profile pages for the kids just so they can tag them in them. You know, they're gonna be, you know, 15 or 16 whenever they feel it's appropriate for them to actually have a Facebook account, and there's gonna be 16 years of back history.
Yeah.
And they're not gonna have any choice in the matter, and that shit's been out there forever anyway.
Yeah.
So it's nice to see that most people, when they're talking about their kids online, they choose like an initial or something like that.
I don't tag them or anything. I tag them as my wife usually.
Yeah. Well, you don't tag them, but you can just say, hey, this is, you know, L doing the thing, you know, first day of school for B and G.
Yeah. No, I don't do, I just tag my wife and
no commentation.
Yeah. Usually. Yeah.
So the next thing is, like, you know, so I understand the reasons why people do, like I said, the sexual predators and freaks out there, and you don't want anyone knowing your kid's name or whatever. But, like, what about the pet pages? Have you been friend requested by one of your friend's pets?
Yeah, I won't accept that stuff. Like, that, you know what, I'll even think about reporting him.
That's spam.
That's still against the terms of use, because that is stupid.
Yeah. I mean, I get them, and I think it's sometimes it's kind of funny, but, like, at least there you don't have to worry about as much as like people, you know, creeping on them. So it's kind of funny to, like, we used to tag Franzia as one of our friends in a lot of our pictures. So there was a profile we made up of box wine, and it's
that's
just
hilarious.
Just so that everybody could tag Franzia in all their pictures. So
that's,
I mean,
pretty funny, Franzia.
Yeah. Is that enough? We didn't make enough fun of Spear. We didn't get a mom joke in here, though.
It's true, we didn't. His parents were at his house the other night.
Oh, yeah?
I told him to tell his mother I said hi, and he said inappropriate.
Why is that inappropriate?
I don't know. I think he thinks I'm up to no good. I just wanted to genuinely say hi to his mom.
Yeah.
She seems like a very lovely lady.
I mean, she's a teacher. She's a mother of two, at least.
Spear has a sister?
Yeah. Does he have a sister?
I don't know.
Yeah, he was at her wedding recently. His sister got married recently.
I'll be damned.
Huh.
You think she's cooler than Spear?
I'm just wondering if she looks like Spear. I can't believe we still haven't seen a picture of her.
I'm looking right now to see if I can find one. So what did you learn?
What did I learn? I learned that Facebook needs filter, and I should build it for them, and they should pay me a lot.
That's a good idea. You got some good ideas. I learned that you have some really good ideas.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Sometimes the brain works and does productive things.
When Spear's not here, it's...
Dude, you know what we should totally do?
What's that?
The next time that Spear's not here,
yeah,
we should totally get a sister on as a guest host.
Okay. I will support that.
So if you are Spear's sister and you'd like to be a guest host on our show, why don't you Twitter us at the Twitters at 4Listeners, or check us out on the Facebook at facebook.com/4Listeners.
Facebook us at the Facebooks.
Oh, at the Facebooks.
Email us at the emails. Stitcher us at the Stitchers. What else can we do?
Google us at the Google.
Yep.
Yeah.
iTunes us at the iTunes.
There you go. If you are Spear's sister and you want to get on the show, definitely get in touch with us. We will love to have you, and I think we will have hilarity ensue. And you can tell us all the good stuff. We definitely do a show about Spear.
Yeah.
I think something definitely needs to be done about Spear. All right. Well, thank you all for joining us, and check us out next week.
Long ago, it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories. They're all that's left you.
I think that works.
Well. Yeah.
I think that's going to be great when he listens to that.
Yeah. He's going to get so mad.
He's going to be pissed. He's like, it's dude. Spear didn't do the Easter egg this week. There was nothing in the Star Wars TV show at the end.
I wonder if he forgot.
I asked him. He said, yeah, I didn't do it this week. I was like, what the fuck, you didn't do it this week?
Yeah, nothing. Oh, I'm due.
Douche.
Seriously.
Darr.
Stay out in fucking California. No internet.
Internet hating motherfucker.
I don't know how to use Skype.